click on one of the blue bars on the timeline to see the noteworthy events of that year. Gregor Mendel published the results of his genetic experiments with pea plants, through which he had discovered the fundamental laws of inheritance and the existence of genes. 1911. Thomas Morgan established the fly room, in which, over the next 17 years, he conducted genetic experiments with fruit flies. Morgan and his students, Alfred Sturtevant, Calvin Bridges, Hermann Muller, and others, developed the ideas and provided the proof for the chromosomal theory of heredity, genetic linkage, chromosomal crossing over, and non-disjunction. Morgan went on to win a Nobel Prize in 1933. 1975. Frederick Sanger developed DNA sequencing. 1980. Ray White described the first polymorphic RFLP marker. 1983. The polymerase chain reaction, PCR, was first conceived by Cary Mullis while he was working at Cetus Corporation. The first paper on the technique was not to be published until 1985. 1984. Sir Alec Jeffries developed the first DNA profiling test. It involved detection of a multi-locus RFLP pattern. He went on to publish his findings in Nature in 1985. 1985. Sir Alec Jeffries applied the analysis of hypervariable regions, which he dubbed mini-satellite regions, to genetic identification and paternity testing. Analysis of multiple loci would eventually produce a DNA fingerprint that is specific to a single individual. This technology is known as restriction fragment length polymorphisms, or RFLP. 1986. DNA testing went public with Cellmark Diagnostics and Life Codes Corporation in the United States. Also in 1986, the polymerase chain reaction, PCR, was first described in scientific literature. PCR using locus-specific primers allows direct amplification of loci from small amounts of DNA, reducing the amount of time and DNA template required. Speed, sensitivity, and specificity would soon make PCR the preferred method for genetic analysis in laboratories worldwide. Also in 1986, the human genetics group at Cetus Corporation developed the PCR technique for a number of clinical and forensic applications. This resulted in development of the first commercial PCR typing kit specifically for forensic use, HLA, DQ alpha, or DQA1, about 2 years later. Also in 1986, PCR-based DNA testing, or HLA-DQ-alpha, was first used in People versus Pestinikas to confirm different autopsy samples to be from the same person. The evidence was accepted by a civil court. This was also the first use of any kind of DNA testing in the United States. 1987. Nakamura et al. Described new highly polymorphic genetic loci with variable numbers of tandem repeat, VNTR loci, and developed a series of new VNTR probes for use in RFLP analysis. Also in 1987, Jeffries used DNA testing to help solve the Black Pad murders and to identify the killer as Colin Pitchfork, who later confessed to the crimes. This marked the first case in which DNA evidence was used to determine the identity of a murderer. This also marked the first case in which a prime suspect was exonerated due to DNA evidence. Also in 1987, DNA profiling was introduced for the first time in a U.S. criminal court. Based on RFLP analysis performed by Life Codes, Tommy Lee Andrews was convicted of a series of sexual assaults in Orlando, Florida. Also in 1987, New York versus Castro was the first case in which the admissibility of DNA was seriously challenged. It set in motion a string of events that culminated in a call for certification, accreditation, standardization, and quality control guidelines for both DNA laboratories and the general forensic community. 1988. FBI began DNA casework with single locus RFLP probes. Also in 1988, Jeffries et al. Showed that PCR can be used to faithfully amplify entire VNTR loci, allowing genetic testing to be performed with far less DNA than previous techniques. Also in 1988, variable regions of mitochondrial DNA were analyzed for human identification purposes. 1989. Technical Working Group on DNA Analysis Method, TWGDAM, established. Also in 1989, the New York versus Castro case raised issues over quality assurance of laboratories. Also in 1989, trimeric and tetrameric short tandem repeats, or STRs, were found to be highly polymorphic and easily amplified by PCR. Size standards, prepared by combining amplification products from individuals of known genotypes, were used to more accurately determine the number of repeats during data interpretation. Also in 1989, Promega first introduced probes for isotopic detection of VNTR loci. 1990. Population statistics used with RFLP methods were questioned. Also in 1990, PCR methods started with DQA1. Also in 1990, K. Kasai and colleagues published the first paper suggesting the D1S80 locus, or PMCT118, for forensic DNA analysis. D1S80 was subsequently developed by CETUS, subsequently Roche Molecular Systems Corporation, as a commercially available forensic DNA typing system. 1991. Fluorescent STR markers first described. Also in 1991, telex extraction developed. 1992. In response to concerns about the practice of forensic DNA analysis and interpretation of the results, the National Research Council Committee on Forensic DNA, NRC1, published DNA Technology in Forensic Science. Also in 1992, Promega first introduced probes for non-isotopic detection of VNTR loci. Also in 1992, STR polymorphisms were discovered on the Y chromosome. Also in 1992, FBI started casework with PCR DQA1. Also in 1992, Thomas Caskey, professor at Baylor University in Texas, and colleagues published the first paper suggesting the use of short tandem repeats for forensic DNA analysis. Promega Corporation and PerkinElmer Corporation, in collaboration with Roche Molecular Systems, independently developed commercial kits for forensic DNA STR typing. 1993. Promega released its first STR detection systems. Also in 1993, sex typing, amelogenin, developed. 1994. The U.S. Congress enacted the DNA Identification Act. The Combined DNA Index System, CODIS, was formally created. Also in 1994, DNA wars declared over. Also in 1994, FBI started casework with PCR-PM. Also in 1994, Roche Molecular Systems, formerly CETUS, released a set of 5 additional DNA markers, polymarker, to add to the HLA-DQA1 forensic DNA typing system. Also in 1994, Applied Biosystems introduced the dot-blot strip for human identification. This DNA-based kit, developed by Roche Molecular Systems, made it significantly easier for forensic scientists to employ DNA-based technology. Applied Biosystems advanced the technology further with a succession of kits, based on fluorescent detection of STRs, short tandem repeats, that significantly improved discrimination and sensitivity, and later by automating the process. 1996. In response to continued concerns about the statistical interpretation of forensic DNA evidence, a second National Research Council Committee on Forensic DNA, NRC2, was convened and published the Evaluation of Forensic DNA Evidence. Also in 1996, the FBI started mtDNA testing. Also in 1996, in Tennessee versus Ware, mitochondrial DNA evidence was first presented in court to help convict Paul Ware of the rape and murder of a 4-year-old girl. Mitochondrial DNA extracted from hairs found at the crime scene and on the child's body was an exact match to that of Ware's. Also in 1996, the first multiplex STR kits became available. 1997, 13 core STR loci defined. Also in 1997, Y chromosome STRs described. 1998, the FBI laboratory established ENDIS, National DNA Index System, which allows federal, state, and local forensic agencies to share DNA profiles of convicted offenders and crime scene evidence. 1999. Multiplex STR kits were validated in numerous labs. Also in 1999, the FBI stopped testing DQA1 PM D1S80. 2000. The FBI and other labs stopped running RFLP cases and converted to multiplex STRs. Also in 2000, the PowerPlex 16 system, which allows amplification of all 13 CODIS loci in a single reaction, was made available by Promega. 2002, the Division of Forensic Science Laboratory in the Commonwealth of Virginia became the first state laboratory to mark 1,000 cold hits from its DNA database. 2003. In Washington versus Tuelafano and Lea Lawaili'i, a murder case that was believed to be the first case in the nation involving dog DNA, the State of Washington Court of Appeals ruled that the science of animal DNA is not as reliable as that of human DNA and cannot be used as evidence in court. Also in 2003, a field DNA test was completed to provide preliminary confirmation of the identity of Saddam Hussein less than 24 hours after his capture. A full test performed in a lab provided confirmation.